you like it?
Where did you find it?
I was on my way up to Maine last year when I had a flat tire. What do you think of it?
It's the kind of place you would find when you have a flat tire.
Well, I've taken out a year's lease to write my autobiography. And what a beguiling name. Beaver Haven.
Oh, don't misunderstand. It's a perfectly charming dump if you're only going to spend a week in CN.
Well, it's perfect. And it has a garden. Do you know all my life I've wanted to raise tomatoes?
It's your frustrated maternal instinct.
And it's already furnished.
That's what you say of a hotel room.
You can't grow tomatoes in a hotel room. And I won't have to change a thing. The problem with you, Tom, is you have no affinity with the earth. You forget I was born on a farm.
You forget that you were hustled off to Hollywood when you were two. And the nearest that you've been to a farm since is Farmer's Market.
And your other trouble is you're a cynic. Instead of an agent, you should have been a mortician.
I feel like a mortician, letting you bury yourself way off here in the sticks.
Well, Beaver Haven is going to be the birthplace of my autobiography. I don't want to die with people thinking I'm the kind of idiot I've always played.
What if somebody recognizes you? You won't have a moment's peace.
How can they? No one knows what I really look like. I've never played myself as I really am. Do you know when I was three, I played a boy, Baby John, like that Lassie series. It was really a male doll playing Lassie. Or was that Rin Tin Tin?
I wasn't born.
And in my teens, I was this buck-toothed idiot girl on this moronic Smithers family. And you know what the past 12 years have been? That damn toothless Granny Gerton and that damn witless Moonlight Mountain series. And that's my trouble. I don't know who I really am. So don't tell me that I can't grow tomatoes. I've been exposed to manure long enough.
Do you realize how much you've made playing Grandma Gerton?
No, but I'm sure the government does.
And to think it's a fortune I could get you for a new series. Got any aspirin?
Never again. I brought all my old costumes with me and I'm going to bury them. For the first time in my life, I'm going to be a real person.
You don't have to come 3,000 miles to be a real person.
In Hollywood? Do you know why I decided to get away from the coast? There's something in the sun out there that saps people's sanity. Calling the old lady's home Lotus Land. Signs saying free psychoanalysis with every hamburger. Bug exterminators advertising, we kill our customers. Do you know I saw a parked truck with a sign that said, a blind man drives this car. I stood for half an hour waiting for that guy to come out, and do you know what it was? A firm that sells Venetian blinds.
Come on, Myra, it's no worse than any place else.
And don't call me Myra anymore. Myra Marlowe is dead. From now on, I'm using the name I was born with.
Good Lord, I'd forgotten you had a real name.
You see, I'm just merchandise. To you, I'm nobody but Myra Marlowe, and you've been my agent for 20 years.
All I remember is it's the kind of name that you forget. Myrtle something or other horrible.
Myrtle terrible. And don't say anything. It's the only thing about me that was ever real.
My God, your mother must have been phonetically deaf.
My mother happened to love flowers.
Well, my mother loved sweet peas, but she didn't name me one.
Myrtle Marigold Dirtle. Someone who was really born.
Mert rhymes with dirt. Well, you ought to be able to grow tomatoes.
And I will. And for the next year, I'm going to be Little Myrtle Dirtle again. And no one's going to know who I am, or where I am, or what I'm doing. And I'll be free to write about my life in the boot tube. You forget, Myrtle also rhymes with fertile.
When I'm back on the coast, I'll think of you fondly as Fertile Myrtle Dirtle.
Oh, stop being a wit. I'm going to live with honest people for a change.
Myra, I mean, Mert. I know you, sweetheart. You get these compulsions. I've seen you take up everything from yoga to yogurt. Do you remember when you were going to adopt that Navajo baby?
Yes, yes, and that's been my whole life. I don't know who I really am, and now I'm going to find out. Besides, I've made a lousy Navajo mother.
All right, so you want to be a writer. Where have I heard that before?
Yes, I am. I'm going to sit down faithfully every morning and dictate the story of my life into that little Japanese thingamabob.
That I've got to see. Or hear. Wasn't it Yeats who said, there are 1,000 things to tempt me from this craft of writing?
I know. So, I dictated a little dialogue with myself. It's a sort of self-conducted catechism. Listen.
Good morning, dear.
That's the other me. Good morning. I thought I'd start off on a cheerful note.
What is your name, dear?
Myrtle Marigold Dirtle. That's so I'll get used to it again.
You should live so long.
What are we here for, Myrtle, dear?
We are here to lead a normal, healthy life, work hard, and find inner happiness.
And raise tomatoes.
Just what kind of work are you going to do, dear?
We are going to write a book.
Not we, dear. You.
Do you go on calling yourself dear?
It makes me feel someone cares.
Dear.
The story of Myrtle Dirtle, or so far so good.
Are you going to let anything distract you?
Only death.
You forgot to call yourself dear.
I know, so I corrected it.
Sorry about that, dear.
Carry on.
Are you sorry to have given up Hollywood, dear?
Are you crazy?
Someone is.
Are we going to work faithfully every day, dear?
6:30 every morning.
Myrtle, dear, you know very well that you haven't been up at 6:30 in the morning since the day you were born. And that was 7:30.
All right, 8 o'clock. I put that bit in to show you can't fool yourself.
You fooled me.
How many hours, dear?
Oh, say 4.
Say 8.
No, 4. I put, you can't let your alter ego run your life.
Well, goodbye and good luck. Nice talking to you, dear.
You too.
You know, I think you were right to hide out up here. It's time you got out of circulation.
Well, when you look back on your life, you have to have a sense of humor.
Why don't you record 3 more voices and maybe you could play bridge?
Do you know what you could do for me now?
Call a good psychiatrist?
Drive down to the village. It's only a few blocks. And pick me up the basic things I'll need. Sugar, salt, eggs, coffee, bread and butter, and a copy of Life magazine.
I doubt I could get your basic needs at a grocery store.
Oh, and no cream. I'm going to lose weight, too.
Why not? You've already lost everything else, including your sanity.
Stay as sweet as you are. Don't let a thing ever change you.
Good morning, dear.
Oh, shut up.
What is your name, dear?
Lassie, what's yours?
What are we here for, Myrtle, dear?
We just may open a house of ill repute. I've always wanted to be a madam.
Not we, dear. You. What kind of book are you writing, dear?
Pornographic.
Are you going to let anything distract you?
Oh, just the usual everyday preoccupations. Sex, dope, liquor, incest, you name it, I'll try it.
Oh. We rang, but no one answered.
But we heard voices.
Oh, sorry about that, dear.
Oh, sorry, I was practicing my Spanish lesson. Buenos dias.
Oh, we're the hospitality ladies.
I'm Cora Gump. I live catty cornered from you on Pussy Willow.
And I'm Reba Harper. I'm behind you on Coolidge.
Clara Thrupp was coming too, but she ate a bad oyster. Oh, well, do come in. I'm Mrs. Wait a minute. Mrs. Dirtle.
Myrtle! Cora, who does her voice remind you of?
Not only that, they look alike.
They could be sisters.
It's uncanny.
Mrs. Dirtle, do you know who you look like?
Everybody?
My daughter's music teacher.
A woman, I hope. Oh, a lovely person. Tone deaf.
Well, we brought you a hospitality basket.
Just a few basic things.
Sugar, salt, eggs, bread, and butter. And a copy of the Life magazine.
And a jar of tomatoes I put up last summer. Oh, I adore tomatoes. I can't wait to grow my own.
Oh, it was a bad year for tomatoes. You know, cutworms, mealybugs, aphids, whitefly, black spot, and blossom rot.
I cut out the rot parts. Well, I know I'll enjoy them.
Just something to welcome you and your husband to Beaver Haven.
Oh, that wasn't my husband. That's just a friend from back in California helping me to get settled.
But you are married, aren't you?
Divorced.
Any children?
No, but I almost adopted one once.
Well, we certainly hope you like Beaver Haven. It's a lovely place. No crime, no scandal.
Except for the Becker boy.
Cora, we don't mention that.
Who's the Becker boy?
Oh, a farmer's son. Cora, why didn't you mention that? Mrs. Durtle will give the wrong impression of our morals.
Well, what did the Becker boy do?
Oh, you know how little boys are.
No, I don't. How are they?
Well, being raised on a farm, you can guess.
With an animal?
Cora!
Well, he tried to.
You mean...
The whole family are atheists. What could you expect?
Well, what kind of an animal?
A turkey.
Cora, it was not a turkey. I went to the trial.
Well, Willa Mae Wilcox said it was a turkey.
They didn't even raise turkeys.
If it wasn't a turkey, what was it?
I'm not going to say. The Beckers have suffered enough.
Does the Becker boy live close to me?
Oh, not anymore. He grew up and joined the Navy.
And a good thing.
It's a lovely place. You don't even have to lock your door at night unless you walk in your sleep.
Pity the Beckers didn't lock the chicken coop.
Cora!
Well, why would Willa Mae Wilcox lie to me?
You know how Willa Mae is.
But who's Willa Mae Wilcox?
Oh, a lovely woman.
Colorblind.
Mad as a hatter. Do you remember the first house on the left as you turned off Coolidge with the purple shutters and geraniums and milk cans?
With the plaster dwarf on a toadstool in the front yard?
That's Willa Mae.
I wouldn't be too friendly with her if I were you.
You can say that again.
I wouldn't be too friendly with her if I were you. Well, I don't like to gossip.
She'll find out anyhow.
Oh, well, are you Pisces?
Why? No, I'm Gemini. Why?
She hates anyone who's Pisces. It's an obsession with her.
Why? Her husband was a Pisces. What did he do to her?
Well, I don't like to gossip.
It's what she did to him.
What did she do to him?
Do you believe in such things as witches?
Oh, well, I'm one myself.
No, I mean real witches, the kind that cast evil spells.
And stick pins in their enemies until they die.
Cora, they do not stick pins in their enemies. They stick pins in their enemies' pictures for dolls that look like them.
It doesn't make a difference.
They die anyhow.
Is that the kind of witch she is?
Well, we can't prove it. And we certainly don't have witch trials anymore.
More's the pity. But when her husband died, they found his picture full of pins and needles.
Didn't she like him?
They didn't speak for 10 years.
Slept together, though.
Why didn't they speak?
Oh, he did something spiteful. I don't like to talk about these things.
What did he do?
Flushed her goldfish down the toilet.
Why?
Said he couldn't stand them staring at him.
I'd hate to be on the wrong side of her.
You can say that again.
I'd hate to be on the wrong side of her.
Well, you certainly have some interesting people here in Beaver Haven. Where is the dam?
What dam?
The one with the beavers.
There are no beavers here.
Why do they call it Beaver Haven?
It was named after an Indian.
Chief Big Beaver.
So there aren't even any little beavers?
You know, there aren't even any Indians. Just a few skunk.
Well, I hate to live in a place called Skunk Haven.
I just know you're going to love it here. And don't worry about Willa Mae.
Unless you give her your picture and some pins and needles.
Well, we know you want to get settled, so we'll leave.
Willa Mae not only has a bad temper, she has a bad dog. So don't walk past her house without a stick.
I won't walk past her place at all.
And remember, if you need anything at all, I'm catty-cornered on Pussy Willow.
And I'm behind you on Foolit. Oh, one more thing. If a man knocks at your door, a man about 6.5 feet with stoop shoulders and dragging an axe, don't let him in.
I'm not bloody well likely to.
That's Mr. Piney.
He's an awful bore. Chops wood and sells manure.
Smells bad, too.
Let him in and you'll never get rid of him.
You know, it's even harder to get rid of his smell. He traps skunk.
Oh, well, it's very kind of you ladies to warn me about these things.
We are the hospitality ladies.
Thank you.
I think you and I ought to have another talk.
Good morning, dear.
It started out that way.
What is your name, dear?
Mud.
What are we here for, Myrtle, dear?
Dog dodging, witch hunting, and needlework.
Just what kind of work are you going to do, dear?
We just may write a book about the universality of insanity.
Not we, dear. You.
No, we. I'm going to need your help.
Who were the two biddies that just left?
The Happiness Girls. They did a community commercial.
No, really?
Neighbors. One's catty corner on Pussy Willow, and the other one's behind me.
You're in a bad spot.
Oh, you wouldn't believe the people here. Do you know I have a witch on my block?
I was once married to one.
And guess who Beaver Haven's named after?
Gloria De Haven?
An Indian. Chief Big Beaver. And talk about a scandal. Guess what happened here?
Someone seduced the church organist with an apple.
Would you believe a turkey and a nasty little boy?
Heaven help us. Isn't Thanksgiving sacred anymore?
And remember that house we passed on the corner with the plaster dwarf on a toadstool?
You want one for Christmas?
No. That lady that lives there stuck pins in her husband and killed him.
My ex-wife was always doing that, only she used nails.
You don't seem very impressed.
I've been in television too long. Sweetie, why don't you kick this compulsion and come back to the coast with me? I don't have to pay alimony anymore. I'll make an honest woman of you.
Tom, we know each other too well. One marriage was enough for me too. Do you want some advice? Never marry a man who looks in the mirror before he says good morning to you, or who gargles while you're putting on your eyelashes.
Thank you. If I ever marry a man, I'll be sure he doesn't gargle while I'm putting on my eyelashes.
You're a pussycat, Tom. And if I ever decide to make some man unhappy again, you will be my first choice.
Well, you'd better hurry. I'm crowding the halfway mark. By the way, how old are you?
Well, let's just say I'm past puberty, but on this side of senility.
Well, if you won't work for me, and you won't marry me, I might as well go. Do you mind if I drop in on you while I'm back east?
Of course not, sweetie. But just be sure you don't tell anybody else. I've told everybody that I'm going on a trip around the world.
Oh, no one goes around the world. Everyone's trying to get off. Well, take care. And good luck.
Drive carefully. Chapter 1, So Far, So Good, by Myra Marlowe. I was born on a small farm in Iowa on a lovely May morning in the year 1930. Change that, make that 1932. On second thought, make it 1935. Oh, Mrs. Durdle, I wanted you to know that I just spoke with Willa Mae Wilcox, and it was a turkey.
Thank you. Pardon, ma'am.
Who are you?
Potty.
Oh.
All right.
I didn't hear you.
Figured you didn't.
I was upstairs.
Figured you was.
What can I do for you?
See this?
It's an axe, isn't it?
A chop wood.
How nice. Out in the open air and all that.
Chop more than any man in that cave.
Oh, is that where you live?
This side.
Sounds like a lovely place. Well, so you chop wood.
Need any?
Actually, I hadn't given it any thought yet. You see, I only arrived yesterday.
Don't see none.
Well, neither do I, but that's probably because it's spring and one doesn't burn wood until fall, does one?
Costs more.
Well, if you happen to have some with you, I'll take a few sticks.
$10 a cord.
That sounds reasonable. It isn't as if I were burning money.
$15 come winter.
Well, then I'd be prudent to buy it now, wouldn't you say? A penny saved, you know. I'll take $10 worth.
Deck, dumped, or stacked?
Oh, do I have to make that decision now?
Sure would.
Well, whichever's easiest. I wouldn't want to put you in any trouble.
You say.
Stacked, then.
Costs more.
I figured it might. How much more?
2 bits.
I think I can swing it. We have a deal.
And breakfast.
Oh, breakfast too? Why's that?
I come early.
Oh, you do? All the way from Batcave? How early?
6.
Oh, that is early. Couldn't we make it 8?
Kill hogs at 8.
Oh, well, afternoon is perfectly all right.
Not for me.
Why not?
A trap skunk.
Well, anytime then. Now that I've placed my order, I won't detain you. I have work to do.
You work?
I'm a writer.
Horseback!
Not a rider, a writer. I write.
What?
I'm writing a book. You have read a book before, haven't you?
The Bible?
Well, mine's historical too. It's a story of my life. It's an autobiography.
An auto what?
It's the story of my life.
That's a story?
It's rapidly getting to be. I'm afraid I can't speak to you any longer, Mr. Piney.
Why are you afraid?
My arteries are hardening and time is running out. And I'm sure you have some place to be.
Already went.
I know, you're waiting to be paid.
Wood's not here yet.
No matter, I'll pay you now so you can go. Would you like your, how would you like your money?
In my hand.
I mean cash or check. You do know what a check is, don't you?
Sure. I'll check your chimney.
No, wait, look. Please don't bother.
Probably needs cleaning.
Well, I'll call you.
When?
Next winter.
Costs more.
No matter. Here's your money.
Cheaper now.
It's not that. I'm going to be very busy. And I'm sure it's time to kill your hogs, but you can bring the wood by any time.
Pine or spruce?
Whichever is handy.
Oak's good.
Good, then you can bring me oak.
Dogwood's better.
Mr. Piney, it really doesn't matter.
Sure does.
Why? As long as it's wood, I couldn't care less.
Pine, pops, spruce, sparks, oak, smokes, and dogwood dries.
All right, bring me a little of each.
Locust is better.
Fine, then just bring me a cord of locust.
Don't grow here.
Oh. Mr. Piney, I've never been fussy about wood. Pussy willow or dogwood, just bring me something that burns.
Ha! All burn. Ha!
Mr. Piney, I'm sure they are worth about you back in Batcave. You've been gone for so long. Now, I'm not going to be blamed for keeping you. I could talk to you all day, but I refuse to monopolize your time. You must leave now before your pigs miss you. It's been a pleasure to have met you. Goodbye.
My pleasure.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes, I got born. When I was still a baby, my mother took me to Hollywood in hopes that I could be...
Need manure?
No!
Got a garden?
Later!
Cheaper now.
All right, all right. Bring me some manure.
How much?
A couple of pounds. It really doesn't matter.
$6 a yard.
Fine. Bring me a yard and a half of manure.
Horse or cow?
Reindeer, buffalo, it doesn't matter.
Sure does matter what you plant.
Mr. Piney, I'm a very nervous woman. If you don't close this door, by the time I count to three, they are going to hear me scream all the way to Batcave. Now, do you want that?
Nope.
Until I was 9, I played Baby John with a talking horse that was 5 years older than I was. When I could no longer play a boy, I was cast in the role as Sis Sadie in the Smithers family. I sincerely pray that none of you are old enough to remember. I wore thick glasses, black pigtails, and a look of gleeful idiocy, which gives you a rough idea of the high level of comedy we provided.
That's a scorpion. Would you trust a scorpion?
Well, she spoke very highly of you.
Did she? What'd she say?
Nice things. Very nice things. Very.
What things?
How much she admired you and how much she liked you.
That's funny.
Why?
We don't speak.
Well, it wasn't anything specific. She just gave that impression. But she did speak very highly of your needlework.
May I see your hands?
My hands?
Your hands, those things hanging at your sides.
Oh, these? Of course.
I'd like to see them palms up.
Do you read palms?
I read palms, fortunes, tea leaves, cards, dreams, coffee grounds, the past, the future, and spiderwebs.
Well, that must keep you busy. What do you see?
I thought so.
What?
How old are you?
Well, I voted for Dewey.
Spread your fingers.
Are you onto something?
Were you near death in 1959?
No. Why?
That's where your lifeline stops. According to this, you should be dead. Let's see your other hand.
Well, I'm left-handed. Does that matter?
Not to me. Oh, here it is. Your lifeline picks up in this hand.
Something bad?
Do you know Macbeth?
Macbeth who?
Here's the smell of blood still. And all the perfumes of Arabia will not sweeten this little hand.
Where do you see blood? Is there going to be a murder?
What time is it?
Standard Pacific or Mountain?
It doesn't matter. I have a clock in my head. It's time for my seance. I'm calling my husband back.
I thought you didn't speak.
We didn't. But he forgot to tell me where he hid the deed to the house.
But you're leaving me with a murder on my hands.
I'll be back after I talk to my husband. I'm just gonna sneak out your back door. Too many people around here are nosy. Out! Damn spot! That's Shakespeare. Aus Wiedersehen! That's German.
She's crazy! Right out of Bat Cave. Well, this part of my life just might prove to be the most interesting. After playing that silly Sister Sadie character for several centuries, that's a time lapse, not a studio, I was cast in the role. Oh, come on now, this has got to come to a screaming halt. Come in!
Can I see you for a moment?
Of course, is something wrong?
Do you know that I have no close friends. No one I can really talk to.
Oh, now, I'm sure you have lots of friends. Your neighbor, Willa Mae Wilcox, was just here and she said some very, very nice things about you.
What things?
Oh, good. About your flower bed. So what seems to be the problem?
Oh, you wouldn't believe me.
Try me, I believe anything.
You won't tell Reba Harper, will you?
Scout's honor.
I'm just too humiliated to talk about it.
Well, have another drink, if you insist.
I knew you were real the minute I met you.
A real what?
A real human being.
Understanding.
Well, I can't be understanding until you give me something to understand. My husband hit me!
Oh, hard?
Right in the mouth! On my lips, swollen!
Oh, well, not yet. Did he use his fist?
No, Wentworth would never use his fist.
Well, what did he use? A frying pan?
His newspaper! The Beaver Haven Herald! Can you imagine?
Yes, it had been the Sunday Times. It might have knocked your brains out.
And I didn't do a thing.
Well, you must have said something.
Not a word. I just threw a cup of coffee in his face.
Before or after?
Before.
Why?
Because he called me a name.
What?
Oh, I just don't know you well enough.
We'll have another drink.
Just a splash. I think my bridge is broken.
Well, now, what did he call you?
Oh, I couldn't say.
Try, I've heard everything.
Maybe I could write it on a piece of paper?
Don't say I didn't warn you. Do you think I should lock the doors?
I hope you can read my handwriting.
Well, that's true of all females, at least anthropologically.
But I'm his wife.
Well, what did you do to provoke him?
When he refused to eat my soup, I called him a name.
What?
Oh, I just don't know you well enough.
Well, write it.
I'm not sure of the spelling. I heard a man call another man this in the movies once. They say anything nowadays. Don't look at me while you read it.
Oh, well, I think it needs to be hyphenated. Izzy?
You know what it means, don't you?
Well, yes, I've gone to the movies myself. But Izzy?
When you're mad, it just doesn't matter.
Well, now we're getting down to the real nitty-gritty. What started it?
Well, he lost his temper when he found a fly in his soup.
Well, what did he expect, a butterfly?
If he put screens up in the house, like I asked, there wouldn't be any flies. What can I do?
Strain the soup and give it back to him.
Oh, no. I am never going back there again.
Well, where will you go?
Can I stay here for a few days?
You mean, move in?
I won't be in the way.
But you didn't bring your toothbrush.
I'll use my finger.
Well, I really don't think it would work out, Mrs. Stomp.
Why not?
Well, for starters, I don't have any room.
You've got a spare bedroom by the back staircase.
Oh, that. Well, that's being used.
For what?
My sister is using that.
You've got a sister?
Ever since she was born.
Where did she come from?
Oh, now, Mrs. Gump, surely you know where little babies come from?
But why haven't we seen her?
She never leaves her room.
Oh, is she an invalid?
Well, yes and no.
Why can't she leave her room?
Well, it's hard to explain, but I will try. You see, when she was about 10 years old, a horse threw her on her head, and she stayed a little girl in the body of a woman.
Oh, is she violent?
Only to strangers.
Oh, you poor woman.
I knew there was something odd about you the minute I met you. I said to myself, there's something odd about her. There's something very odd about her.
You can say that again.
I just did. What's her name?
My sister?
Mm-hmm.
Sadie. Sis Sadie.
Could I meet her?
Oh, I wouldn't dare.
Does she ever go out?
I couldn't risk it.
What does she do all day?
Well, she has a pair of scissors, and I give her the newspaper, and she enjoys cutting people's heads off.
Oh, good heavens.
Well, I can see why you'd want to be left alone. I wouldn't dream of imposing on you any longer. Could I have one more for the road?
Oh,
by all means, take the
just
bottle.
Just a little trickle to oil the tonsils.
Glass?
No, I don't need that.
You are a saint. A living saint. I like you.
That's nice.
Very much.
Thank you.
Very, very, very much.
Well, now you'll see if I'm not very social.
Don't you say that. Don't you put yourself down. You know what you are.
Sometimes I wonder.
A living saint.
Oh, no. This way out.
Goodbye, dear.
And thank you for the tea.
Yes.
Now I've done it. Well, maybe I'll get a little privacy. The next role I was asked to play was... Now what? Obscene answering service. Who? Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Harper. I didn't know anybody had this number. Yes, I like pie. Why? Oh, now I couldn't let you do that. I'll come by later and pick it up. Well, if you insist, bring it over while it's hot. No, that's my trouble. No, I wasn't doing a thing. All right, just come on in.
Damn it. To put a stop to this.
Well, I've stuck my toe in the water. I might as well dive.
Sister Meadow! I got my door unlocked. I got out. You've got someone down there that's come to put me away. If anyone's down there, I'll kill them. I'll cut their ears off. I've got my scissors.
She still plays with dolls? That's unusual.
Well, not for her. You see, when she was a girl, she had an accident, and she's only grown physically.
I knew there was something tragic in your life. I said to myself the moment I met you, there is something tragic in that woman's life.
Mrs. Harper, I think you put your finger on something. Do you bake your own bread?
Oh, you don't fool me.
Oh, I must be a lousy actress.
You're hiding from the world, tied hand and foot, and you didn't want us to discover the truth about you.
Really have put your finger on something.
No one to talk to. Your life destroyed by wolves. Well, dear, you can pour out your heart to me. I brought my knitting, and me and you are going to spend the whole day here talking about your problem.
Well, it's really not a problem. It's like being the keeper of a beautiful tiger. As long as it's caged, there's no problem.
I know my Christian duty. Cry if you feel like it.
I too. If you will excuse me for just a minute, I'm going to take that pie into the kitchen. Now, I won't be a minute.
Take your time. You know, you shouldn't ought to feel badly, Mrs. Dirtle. This sort of thing happens in the best of families, particularly around Boston. We had a case just like yours right here in Beaver Haven in 1966. No, it was 1967 because that was a bad year for tomatoes. A family named Plank moved here from Duck Pond. Sabrina Plank, that was Leslie's wife. She was a Pepper before she was a Plank. She had this boy they called Splinter. Anyhow, he fell out of a butternut tree and landed right on his head. Dr. Greenleaf, he's dead now. He put a steel plate in the boy's head. Electricity gave him a headache, but he developed the loveliest complexion. That happens sometimes. I think I trade what brains I've got for a good complexion any day. Oh, I thought you were in the kitchen.
Oh, I took my sister a piece of pie.
Well, I've got our whole day planned. I'll fix your lunch and your dinner, too. I do wonderful things with beans.
Sister Merle.
Oh, my goodness. I must have forgotten to latch that door.
I got my door unlocked. I got out.
Oh, I'll have to catch her before she gets to us.
You've got someone down and it's time to put me away.
There's no one down here, dear.
If anyone's down there, I'll kill them. I'll cut their ears off. I've got my scissors.
And she will, too. Don't run with your scissors, dear. I'm coming right up. Oh, fortunately, I studied judo. Now, just make yourself at home. I'll only be a few minutes. With luck.
So did I. Well, the words are... Oh, wait a minute. The first word is... Well, I'm not going to shout it! It's too embarrassing. Look, I'll bring them over to your house. I just hope I'm not run over and have them found on my body. Stay there.
Sure.
series. Going on here?
Tom! What are you doing here?
Would you mind explaining what that's all about?
Oh, it's too complicated. Where'd you come from?
New York. I called at least 20 times. No answer!
Well, I don't answer the phone anymore.
Then why have you got it?
Somebody might call. what are you doing out east?
I'm here to see you. Would you explain this?
Well, when I first got here, people kept bothering me, so I taped something, and when people barged in, I would take it upstairs and answer it down here, and it would scare away visitors.
It almost scared me away. Getting any work done?
Every morning. I'm up to my wedding night.
What are you made up for, little Bo Peep?
I was gardening. 10:30 is my tomato break.
Well, I knew you weren't Joan of Arc. She didn't wear a hat.
Well, you wouldn't expect me to dig in a Dior, would you?
Are you? I would. And with a flashlight. At night.
I can't tell you how wonderful it is to plant a seed and watch it grow, pushing its little head up through the earth, reaching its arms out to the sun. And then, one morning at dawn, you go out to spray, with the stars still shining, and there's a little baby tomato.
You make it sound like the nativity.
I can't tell you how rewarding it is to see something grow. And tonight, I'm eating my very first tomato out of my very own garden. If you want to stay for dinner, I'll share it with you.
That's your entire crop?
I put in too much manure. The plants all went to leaves, but I'm learning.
I'll bet it cost you at least $15 to grow that one tomato.
18. But what's money? You can't eat it. And you can't buy the joy I get in looking out at my beautiful green tomato garden, even if there aren't any tomatoes on it.
Oh, Myra, why are you wasting your time and talent here when you could be doing something really important?
I wish I had two. I could put up some ketchup.
That's why I'm here. CBS wants you for a terrific new series.
Do you know about rhododendron? It's non-chemical, but the bugs just hate it.
It's a sensational idea. There's never been anything like it before on television.
There is nothing like rhododendron. It's sensational. It kills aphids, beetles, cutworms, black fly, you name it, and it's dead.
CBS thinks so much of this that they put 15 writers on it. That's two more than the president has.
Now you take manure. I thought it would be better if it were fresh. Everything else is. But no, it burns the tender little sprouts. I murdered my poor little beans!
To hell with your beans! Listen to what they've come up with. Every actress in Hollywood is gonna want to cut her throat when they find out that you've got the role.
Well, that makes it tempting.
This is a character you believe. She's real. You love her. You identify with her.
Mary Magdalene?
Nah, the Bible is dead as a box office. This is today. And what today is all about, it's now.
Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Crime. It's everywhere. So we start with a built-in audience, but it's a male audience. So what do we do to hook a female audience? Guess what our protagonist is, and think big.
A lady gorilla.
You're a detective. The first female detective we've ever had on television.
It took 15 writers to come up with that. It only took 12 to write the Bible.
You haven't heard the best part.
Go on, I've heard the worst.
You're blind.
You're kidding.
It's a fantastic idea. Dig this. You've been blind since childhood, so you've had to develop your sense of touch, your sense of smell, your sense of hearing. You see things that escape other people. You're an inspiration to the handicapped and women's lib. And we start but with built-in sympathy. I mean, who could hate a blind woman detective?
I could.
They'll give you four knocks.
And they should.
Nothing will be spared.
Except me.
It's got universal appeal. It doesn't offend anyone.
Except the blind.
It's got to be a winner. It doesn't alienate, it's not controversial, it shuns touchy subjects, it skirts involvement.
Who would sponsor a program like this? The United Nations?
We've already got a sponsor. Hallmark.
Hallmark? I'm giving up wrapping paper.
Oh, they're no fools. This opens up another market. Christmas cards in Braille.
I'm giving up Christmas cards.
In other words, it doesn't grab you.
That's the understatement of the year.
Stinks, doesn't it?
You know it does.
I agree. It's the lousiest idea that anyone has ever had.
Then why did you bother to tell me about it?
Myra, I would do anything to get you back on the coast with me. I miss you like hell. I knew you wouldn't go for it, but I thought, at least I'd try.
Oh, Tom, you dear sweet nut, I'm touched and flattered. But I'm out of that weird world of insanity. I have everything I need here.
Sperm for a tomato.
I'm through with show business once and for all. Do you know what I did yesterday?
Sprayed your garden for cutworms?
I took all my old costumes and wigs in the backyard and buried them.
Always the actress.
I know, but I wanted it to be symbolic. I'm through with that life. Over. It's buried. May it rest in peace.
Did you give your own eulogy?
Well, I was going to, but it started to rain. So, tell me about yourself. Are you still dating that horrible redhead with the lisp?
She does not have a lisp. It's a slight whistle.
You ought to keep her around. She'll come in good for calling dogs, taxis, and waiters.
Why are you so bitchy about the women who find me irresistible?
Because you always throw yourself away on these vacuous little nitwits. You're too good for that.
I agree with you. But I'm a sexy Boy Scout.
It's a pity I didn't meet you when I was 19. I could have made something out of you.
Yeah, an alcoholic. Well, if you won't be my wife, or a blind detective, I might as well get back to my whistling redhead.
Are you sure you don't want to stay for dinner and share my tomato?
Share your life with me, and you've got a deal.
Tom, I'm not 19, I'm not a redhead, and I can't whistle.
Are you really happy here?
Absolutely.
No problems?
When your life is simple, your problems are simple.
And you couldn't use a man around the house?
Not a tomcat.
Well, in that case, I'll leave you to your rural paradise. May you stagnate in grace and beauty.
I'll walk you to the car so the neighbors won't think you've left me in bed.
You in? You out?
I'll know at once. I can hear a pin drop. Somebody drop a pin! The murder weapon was a .32 bazooka. I know the smack of a .32 bazooka. I will detect the criminal by his body temperature. I'll examine you first, sir. You, our chair. But beware! My famous nose will smell you out. Did somebody bring a horse in here?
Play acting?
Yes, no. What are you doing here?
Watching you.
What do you want?
Nothing.
Then why are you here?
You like nuts?
Some of my best friends are. What kind are they?
Hickory.
Where'd you get them?
Hickory tree.
Well, I don't know what I'd do with that many nuts.
Stuff a turkey.
Somehow I wish you hadn't said that.
Want them?
Well, I can't take them for nothing. You must let me give you something.
Two bits.
That sounds reasonable. I think I can swing that.
Without the sack.
I thought there'd be French benefits. How much for the gunny sack?
Dime.
Well, I don't seem to have a dime in change. Would you take an airmail stamp?
Nope.
Well, you could write someone.
Can't write.
Well,
why don't you dump the nuts into the dishwasher and keep your gunny sack? Now, you have to excuse me. I have work to do. Now what?
Need manure?
No, I think I have a few handfuls left.
Got a hammer?
A hammer. What do I need a hammer for?
Crack nuts.
I'll find a rock.
Wanna borrow my axe?
Really, Mr. Piney, I will find some way of cracking them.
I'll help. Yeah. caught her?
I caught her.
She hurt you?
Nope.
You okay?
Yeah.
You are out of breath.
Well, you went up there to see how fast I had to move.
Want water?
Oh, heavens to Betsy, you're limping.
Got kids.
Oh, hard?
Hard enough.
Well, she's like that when she's crossed. So sorry you have to leave.
Came in the back.
Well, it's okay. We'll go out the front.
Left my boots. Know what?
Not much.
I liked her. She's pretty.
Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the biggest fool of all? Don't answer.
Mrs. Turtle, are you all right?
Of course, why not?
I heard someone screaming for help. I thought someone was being murdered.
Well, I can explain that easily.
You can?
Well, yes, it might take a little bit, but I can explain. You see, I was listening to the TV.
That's funny.
Why?
You don't have a TV.
Oh, well, that does make it harder, doesn't it? What I meant to say was the radio.
Well, I would have been here quicker to save you, but I couldn't find my hat pin.
Your what?
There's no better weapon than a hat pin.
You were going to save me with a hat pin.
Save my grandmother from kidnapping more than once.
Saved her more than once or from kidnapping more than once?
Lived in deadly fear of being kidnapped. Also, carried chili powder to throw in their eyes. You got any chili powder?
No, but I've got a can of chili.
I'll lend you my hat pin. How's your sister?
Exhausted.
Cora Gump told me all about her. You're making a grave mistake.
You know, Mrs. Wilcox, I'm inclined to agree with you.
I'd like to see her.
Oh, well, she had a very bad day, and that's the God's truth.
I could cure her for you.
Well, we've been to the very best doctors.
Wax.
Well, science is useless in a case like this.
Do you love her?
We're very close.
Then I'll cure her for you. I cured a mad dog. But I'll have to wait till the moon is right.
So when will that be?
When those men stop walking on it.
I would hate to put you to any trouble, Mrs. Wilcox, and the government.
No trouble. When was she born?
Oh, she's a Gemini. We're twins.
It's good. They respond better. I'll need a hank of her hair and some mugwort. Does mugwort make her sick?
The very sound of it makes me sick.
I know where it grows wild. I'll pick some.
I really don't think she would eat it.
You don't eat it. You rub it on.
Oh, well, I really don't think that would work.
You want her to be normal, don't you?
Well, Mrs. Wilcox, I've often asked myself, does the normal girl want to be rubbed with mugwort?
Call me Willa.
Willa.
Now, does she cut her nails or do you?
Both. I do her fingers, she does her toes.
I'll need some clippings.
Oh, I think we've thrown those away.
Cut some more. Thursday's a good day. There's an eclipse. I'll be back for the hank of hair. Oh! Don't wash it. That's important. What are you doing with the axe?
Cracking nuts.
Cut yourself?
No. Why?
There's blood on it. Save a smear for the mugwort. Works miracles. I'll be back.
Oh, no. You're not coming back, and neither is anyone else. I wonder if I can dig a moat with a trowel. Oh, good Lord. She must have forgotten her hatpin. Well, she knows I'm here. Just a minute. Come in.
We just met Willa May.
She told us. That is, she told Cora. She doesn't speak to me.
Told you what? Don't let her do it.
Did she tell you she cured a mad dog?
I bet she didn't tell you about all the other ones that died.
Did she mention juniper berries?
Just mugwort. She's always experimenting with weeds.
Don't let her touch your sister.
Because we know the only person who can cure her.
Who? Brother Leviticus. You wouldn't believe the people he's cured by faith alone. Miracles.
You can say that again.
Miracles. And he'll be here next week for a big tent revival meeting, right in Beaver Haven.
He's the Lord's right hand.
No medicine, no pills, no nothing. Just faith and prayer.
And a small contribution. Ladies, I appreciate your concern, but my sister is happy the way she is. Hers is a better world than ours.
Well, we've taken the bull by the horns, dear. We wrote to Brother Leviticus about your sister.
It's all arranged.
Your sister is to sit up on a platform and be healed before everybody in Beaver Haven.
And Batcave. Oh, no. I couldn't let her do that in front of people.
Why not?
She has a cold.
Oh, he'll cure that too. I've seen him cure appendicitis, phlebitis, peritonitis, tonsillitis, laryngitis, meningitis, arthritis, hepatitis, bronchitis, and gastritis.
And flatulence. Well, believe me, it would take more than a miracle. Well, we are not going to let you sacrifice yourself any longer.
So you'll both just have to show up Saturday night.
Maybe you've got something he can cure too.
You better believe it.
It's the most inspiring thing I've ever seen when Brother Leviticus stands up over the lame and halt, a Bible in one hand, a snake in the other.
A snake? Like it says in the Bible?
Where does it say that in the Bible?
And they shall take up serpents before them, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them.
Luke, it doesn't say that in my Bible.
The proof is in the pudding, dear.
Pudding, I'll go for. Snakes? No.
It's a very exciting spiritual experience. You'll find yourself trembling all over.
Oh, you can bet on it. What kind of snake?
Was it a rattler or a copperhead last year that cured my hiccups?
Water moccasin. Oh, I think I'll just stick with the mugwort.
You don't have a thing to worry about. It's settled.
Unless Willa May gets mad at you.
Bye. We'll pick you and your sister up next Saturday.
Well, Mrs. Frankenstein, you've created a monster. And you bloody well better destroy it before it destroys you. Oh, what a tangled web we weave when first we practice to deceive. Luke. Well, Sister Sadie, it looks like it's the end for you. I'm going to take you out to the backyard and bury you. And nothing will ever grow there again. Even tomatoes.
Nope.
Well,
What are you doing, all dressed up?
Come in here.
You sparking?
I come here sparking.
Oh, I cannot believe you have come here sparking. And did you bring flowers for my sister?
Swamp lilies?
Oh. And that's why you're all gussied up and smelling of, by the way, what is that?
Vanilla.
And you brought her candy?
Whorehound.
Well, personally, I wouldn't consider that a compliment, but who am I to say?
Sure liked her.
Oh, you can't mean. Oh, good Lord, you can't mean you've come calling on my sister.
Sure am.
I'm sorry you got all dressed up, Mr. Piney, without wasting all that vanilla, but you can't see her.
Why not?
Well, she isn't with me anymore.
Where is she at?
Away.
Away where?
She's in Boston. I thought she'd be happier in Boston, where they won't notice the difference.
Coming back?
I'm afraid not. She just wasn't happy here, so I put her in a home.
Who's?
It's sort of a hospital. I do hope you didn't go to too much trouble.
Took a bath.
Well, that's a pity. Washing all those vitamins off.
Pick flowers.
Well, maybe someone will die.
Want some candy?
I can try.
Made it myself.
Well, then you must let me pay you. Can you put a price on the candy?
2 bits.
Well, that sounds fair.
Without the box.
How much for the box?
Done.
Well, that makes my sister worth about 38 cents. Here, this will cover the vanilla. I had no idea you found my sister so attractive.
Sexy.
Mr. Penny, you know what the old lady said when she kissed the cow. Each to his own.
Nice behind, too.
Oh. Really? Mr. Piney?
Solid.
Oh, well, thank you. I mean, thank you for her. I'll tell her.
When?
Well, the next time I visit.
I'll go too.
Oh, no. I'm afraid that can't happen. You see, only relatives can visit, and I wouldn't want you to have to take another bath. Come in!
Who's that?
Heidi. Somebody dead? He's sparking.
You?
My sister.
George Washington Piney, you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
What for?
Well, everybody knows she's outdated. You smell terrible. What have you been rolling in?
Vanilla. He smells like cake. He's really gone into a lot of trouble.
Well, don't let him come around courting your sister.
Oh, I think I've taken care of that.
We just spoke with Brother Leviticus. He wants to meet your sister Sadie before the meeting.
Have a teensy-weensy little problem. Come in!
What are you two doing here?
It's a free country.
Hello, Willa.
Who's that?
Piney.
Somebody died?
Yes, the old Piney we knew and loved.
He looks like he's ready to be laid out in his coffin.
You too.
Don't you sass me.
You get pins stuck in you.
I came over to get you know what.
You know what?
What I told you. I need a swatch of your sister's hair.
What fur?
Cat's fur to make kitten britches. I need it tonight if I'm going to cure her. The moon is right.
You're going to cure her?
I don't speak to you. You're Scorpio.
Well, I'm going to speak to you. If anybody is going to cure her, it is going to be Brother Leviticus, not you.
Brother Satan? I've twice as much power in my little finger.
Wrong finger.
You've already spoken to Brother Leviticus.
I've already picked my mugwort.
Ladies, please, there is no need to argue over my poor sister. You see, she isn't with me any longer.
Oh. The Lord taketh and the Lord giveth away.
Amen.
Oh, the Lord lost things. When did it happen?
No, not that. I sent her away. She wasn't happy here, so I put her in a home where she'd be taken care of.
Why didn't you tell me? What am I going to do with all this mugwort?
I'll take it.
Brother Leviticus is not going to be happy about this. Well, when I told my poor sister what you lovely ladies wanted to do, she became so hysterical that I was beside myself. So I called these people and they came and took her away.
Well, where is she now?
Boston.
How do you know?
Asked.
Heathens, they burned witches in Boston.
How am I ever going to please Brother Leviticus?
Merchant a carnival snake, too. Well, I am sorry if I've caused any problems, but well, why don't we all sit down and have a nice cup of tea together?
Might as well. Scotch?
Oh.
Tea?
Tea. I'll read the leaves.
Sarsaparilla.
Okay. Well, the water's warm. I'll only be a minute. It's kind of like a party, isn't it?
Anyone need manure? Just thought I'd ask.
Funny. She sent her away so suddenly.
Guess she don't trust us.
I didn't see anyone come or go.
You know, me neither. And I live catty corner.
You think she's still upstairs?
I'm going to look.
Spry for her age.
Nosy, too.
Well, it does seem kind of strange. Do you think she acted funny, Cora?
Haha, funny or just funny?
Why do you think she had a cherub against the door when we came in?
I was gonna ask.
Ask me. There's something fishy going on here.
You think there's something fishy going on here?
I just said so.
Well, you said to ask.
Guess what I found?
What?
I don't speak to you.
What?
Nothing.
Nothing?
She's not here.
If she's not here, and she didn't leave, where is she?
You don't mean.
I didn't say it.
Say what?
Her own words were, I sent her away.
Oh, Reba, no.
Then she said, she is no longer with me. You know what that can mean, don't you?
Murder. I heard her sister screaming for help myself. She yelled, I'm being killed! I'm being killed! I heard her. Too late.
But they were sisters.
I saw her bury a fox in the backyard yesterday. I just happened to be looking with my spy glasses.
How big a box?
So big.
She was bigger than that.
Not if she was cut up in little pieces.
Piney, have you ever left your axe here before?
Yesterday?
I saw it. There was blood on it. Chopped her up in little pieces.
Don't say that.
Chopped her up in little pieces. Whack! Whack!
You don't know.
I ran her palm. There was murder in her left hand.
Oh, no, it seems.
Willa heard her screaming for help.
I raced over with my hatpin. Too late.
The poor woman was driven out of her mind. Quick, we'll have to get the sheriff. It's our Christian duty.
Find in our own backyard.
Piney, you stay here.
Not me.
Very unusual for Gemini.
Hurry, Cora. It may be you.
You can say that again. Times. I remember this one time we went on a picnic and... That's her!
You! Myrtle! Myrtle!
Blood dripping from her fingers. Out, damn spot!
What are you talking about?
Where's your sister?
Dead in little pieces.
What do you mean? Why are you asking?
Just answer my question. Where's she at?
Where's she at? Well, she's down in Boston.
Where?
At a place.
What's its name?
What's its name? Well, it's funny. I can't seem to think of it at the moment. Oh, yes. Lotus Land.
Get me Boston on the phone.
Oh, but they don't have a phone. What's this all about?
Mrs. Durdle, I'm afraid you're going to have to come down to the jail with me.
What for?
Suspicion of murder.
Who?
Your sister.
Poor little bird, with a broken wing.
Heard it too.
Oh, this is absurd. I can explain everything easily. You see, when I arrived here, I wanted a little privacy. So I invented this crazy half-witted sister. She doesn't exist.
Not now.
Officer, we all saw her. She was real enough.
No, that was me. I was playing a part I played as a child. You never saw us together.
We heard her voice upstairs while you were down here.
That was my own voice, recorded on tape.
Let's hear it.
Well, unfortunately, I erased it this morning after I got rid of that sister character.
She confessed!
And destroyed the evidence.
Look, I might as well tell you all the whole truth. I am really Myra Marlowe. The TV actress.
I moved down here to get away and write my autobiography. Haven't any of you ever heard of Moonlight Mountain?
Oh, I heard of it.
And you don't look any more like Myra Marlowe than I do.
Well, I am grateful for that. Nevertheless, I am me. You probably don't recognize me because I played Granny Gertie. Look, get out of my cabin, you rapscallion, or I'll stick my hound dogs on you. Well, it was a lousy performance, but it gives you a rough idea of the kind of stupid character that I played. I could do it better.
What did you dig into the ground out in your backyard?
Manure.
You buried a box. She in it?
All chopped up. I can explain that easily. I buried some old costumes of mine.
Honey, go see what you can dig up.
It was a theatrical gesture to mark the end of an episode in my life. Very foolish of me.
You can say that again.
It was a theatrical gesture to mark the end of an episode in my life. Is that enough?
How heartless to call your own sister an episode.
This is the worst scandal we've ever had in Beaver Haven.
Except for the Becker boy and the turkey.
You want a lawyer?
I want someone to show a little sanity. Call my agent, Tom Lamont. He will vouch for me. I really am Myra Marlowe.
And I'm Debbie Reynolds.
Where do I reach you?
Come to think of it, he can't. He just left for the coast.
The moving finger writes, and having writ, moves on.
First, you say you're your sister. Then, you say you're somebody else. Don't make any difference who you are if you killed somebody. We don't cop to people killing people here. Well, don't just stand there, say something. Somebody.
Until we find a body.
Let's start with you. What's your name?
Puddin' and Tame. Ask me again and I'll tell you the same!
You clown, and I'm being arrested for murder.
Who's been murdered?
That Sister Sadie character I created. They think I murdered her. Tom, please tell them who I am.
You want to know who she is?
We're waiting!
She's a nut. But she's the best actress in the business. I should know, I've represented her long enough. She couldn't kill anything bigger than a bug. Haven't any of you seen her as Grandma Gerton or Sis Sadie?
Don't forget Baby John.
Why did she pretend she was twins?
I told you already. I came up here to get away from the nosy neighbors.
That's gratitude.
After I baked her a pie and wrote her name in the dough.
Sorry about that.
Sweetheart, it's simple. Record your voice, put on the wig, and show 'em.
All right.
Who's Myra Marlowe?
Here, take my sister's scalp.
Still like the simple life?
Oh, Tom, I cannot tell you how good you looked coming through that door.
Then why don't you come back to the coast with me and play house?
Well, what happened to your whistling redhead?
Married a Navajo cattle king. And to imagine when she could have had me.
Oh, Tom, I can't cheat you. You want a young tomato who's going to give you children.
We'll adopt a beggar boy.
Oh, you know I adore you, Tom, but let me think about it.
All right. I'm not unreasonable. I'll give you 3 minutes.
Oh, Mrs. Dirtle, I wanted you to know that I just spoke to the sheriff himself. And he told me the truth. I thought you'd want to know too, since you live here now. It wasn't a turkey, it was a duck.
You see, they're as crazy here as they are out in Hollywood.
You can say that again.
You see, they're as crazy here as
they are.
Thank you.
our directors to come up for just a second. They have put in a ton of work to help make this come true, and we would just like to realize that Allison's going to take a long time to walk. There she goes. Jump! Don't jump. Okay, while they're coming up, Kathy, thank you. Thank you very much. So, being typecast as someone who continuously delivers manure, I will be giving you this speech. We just wanted to thank both the directors, and the one thing that this show has taught us personally is the best way to show your love to someone is to write their name in crust on a pie. Thank you. And thank you for coming to support us. Thank you for being here. All right, thank you.